a working CRT monitor made out of bricks. After I created this Raspberry Pi Zero case with a screen that didn't work, I toyed with the idea of creating a functional one. I just needed a display to build it around. So, when Sengji from Waveshare asked me if I would like to do a project using anything from their catalog, I obviously asked him about a small screen, which Waveshare was happy to provide. This 3.5-inch 640x480 display is perfect for a build that has the looks of an old CRT. I'll show you the whole building process and all about the screen after the intro. Let me first show you the screen itself. It comes in this white box with the Waveshare name and logo. A nice flat HDMI cable is included, as is this HDMI bridge, a USB A to C cable, an HDMI to, I believe it's mini HDMI bridge, some screws and standoffs, and of course the 3.5-inch display. It has some buttons for controlling stuff. I never really needed them, to be honest, but I did make sure they're accessible in my brick CRT. There's the USB-C connector for power and touch control, and a nice full-size HDMI input, I appreciate that. It has a mini jack and a 4-pin audio output, which is already amplified, so you can hook up passive speakers using the left and right two pins. I did buy a set of speakers from Waveshare myself that already have the right PH 2.0 connector, but these are quite a bit too big for this project, so I didn't use them. There's a small switch to switch from USB-C connectivity to the pogo pins at the lower back side of the screen. With that out of the way, let's start building a bricked CRT. I first created a frame from bricks so I could try to fit the screen. Since I'm just using bricks to hold the screen in place, that was quite a challenge. Next, I made a model based on a frame I had built in Bricklink Studio. I bought most of the bricks I use new because my white ones are mostly yellowed. So I uploaded the model to Rebrickable and exported a list of bricks. I imported that into a wanted list on Bricklink. And removed the bricks I didn't really need to buy and made sure the condition of all bricks was set to new. Note that all blue, yellow and red bricks used in this build are invisible once it's closed up, so I just used old ones and not even the right colors for some of those. Bricklink made me optimized cards for the bricks I wanted, so I could easily go ahead and buy them. Damn, that's less than half of what I have paid. Well. I used Studio to make PDF instructions as well, which I will also be sharing on Rebrickable for free, in case you're interested in building this yourself. Let's first prepare the screen. I used one of the standoffs to make it easier to keep the screen in place and upright. I'm not going to put screws in Lego bricks. Nope. I used the HDMI bridge to route the HDMI cable to the back of the unit, along with this angled HDMI adapter I bought on AliExpress. I used this very flat USB-C cable from AliExpress to route the USB-C connection to the back as well. Mine is 5 cm long, but I'd strongly advise you to get a taller one if you're planning on building along. This one made it a bit hard to tuck away the cables inside. Alright, speed building time! This side will get pretty unstable, but don't worry, we'll fix that later. Alright, about time to add the display. I have connected the HDMI cable and USB-C cable already, as you won't be able to connect them after the model is completed. Making sure both cables are in this opening, as we're going to cover it shortly. I'll add some gray tiles to be the screen bezels, that will also help to keep the screen from falling out of the front. Is the last part of the front bezel. I don't know about you, but I quite like the looks of it already. Let's close her up. Almost done. Let's build a base for it. It can rotate and hinge, but if you want to angle it more or maybe less than I did, you would have to add or remove a plate here. As you can see, I left an opening on this side to be able to reach the buttons on the display. I'll cover them with a tile that can be removed relatively easy, although you'll probably need some tool for that. So here we have our bricked CRT. It's a bit too big to fit on my Pi Zero case though. A mini PC could work, I guess. The touchscreen works out of the box on my machine, but it's not very useful on a desktop with a screen this small. The 640x480 resolution is great for some retro gaming though. Let's try some!
These speakers do sound quite nice actually. They're not going too loud. I've already put them at 150% volume, output volume, so. Who knows? Maybe I'll use them after all. Woohoo! Saved the first woman. On camera, the screen does look quite glary, but I don't see that. Maybe a little bit when I get at the same height of the camera, but it's not as bad as it's shown on screen now. Come, start the game. Somehow not running at a constant speed, and I think I've encountered this before in DustBox, but I don't know the solution anymore.
So how expensive is it to build something like this? As mentioned in the beginning of this video, the display was provided by Waveshare, so I didn't have to pay for that. It's listed for $43.99 at the moment though. The cards that Bricklink created were some 25-ish euros in total, including shipping from two different shops. You might get them cheaper if you choose used bricks, which are usually just fine when sold on Bricklink. So it's hard to give you an exact number, but let's just call it 25 euros, which is about $30. I bought this flat USB-C cable that's just over $2, and this angled HDMI extender that's just over $2.50. So in total this build would cost some $78, or 70-ish in euros. Not too bad, right? That's without any speakers though. I might get myself some smaller speakers to go with it. Is it useful? Not at all. I will probably just put this one on my desk as a prop. Maybe some stats on screen? I don't know yet. What would you do? Tell me in the comments. I hope you liked this build as much as I did. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.